Welcome to my YouTube channel. It's your girl Jay, and this is my first video. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe now. Yes. So I will be talking about my testimony and my very first experience with Jesus. Yes, it's a Christian vlog. Yes, that's what I'm about. It's a Christian vlog. Yes, so I'm gonna be talking about my experience, my very first experience with Jesus. Let's get right into the video. Oh, once you choose it, you can't lose it. There ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. I got an old church choir singing in my soul. I gave my life to Christ when I was 16. Yes, I just entered school. At that point, I was struggling with a lot of things. I was struggling with depression. I was struggling with low self-esteem. I didn't have who to talk to. I didn't have friends. I always felt like everybody was angry with me, and I'm angry with everybody. Like, let's just stay on our own, that kind of feeling. So, I also traveled abroad, but it didn't work out. So I had to go to Igmanajor University. And when I got there, luckily for me, my sister, who used to be a student of that school, connected me with someone who is a student, or who was a student at that time. And when I got there, I stayed with her for like my first year. So when I got there, she invited me to her church. First of all, I loved the way she was. I carried a mindset of, Christians are supposed to be uptight. Christians are supposed to be like no makeup, powder, you know, like the way I'm looking now. Christians are supposed to be on long skirt, no trouser, no short sleeves, just, you know, long sleeve and everything. So when I got there, I saw a very fine, fresh lady who speaks in tongues and prays like a man. Like, the first day I got to her room, that night I slept in her room. Yeah, so about 5 a.m. in the morning, she got up to pray. And when she started praying, the prayer woke me up because it was intense. And she was speaking in tongues and she was praying like, I think she was even crying in her prayers. And she was praying for her members, praying for souls. Yes, I forgot to add that she was a pastor. She was praying for members, praying for souls, praying for the church. And I was so surprised because, like, this is a lady. Ladies are supposed to be fresh and, you know, don't need stress. And Christianity is supposed to be simple. You just need to serve God. When you sin, you repent. And you make sure that when thunder strike like this, you have given your life to Christ so that you can follow God. You can follow Jesus to heaven. Yes. So it was surprising for me because of that fact, that because of the mentality I had when I got there. So I was like, wow, can a lady pray like this? And I didn't really believe so much in speaking in tongues. So it was like, speaking in tongues did not seem like something that was fake anymore when I heard her speak, because she was speaking with power, with intensity, with passion. So it didn't feel fake. Like how I used to think that someone would just come and speak rubbish, rah, 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 shut up, you know, just for the moment. No, it didn't seem like that, because she was praying and she was crying in her prayers and there was passion. So at that point I was like, wow, I want to be like this lady, because I had already I just ended a relationship before I went to school. I was 16 though, but at that point, you know, the relationship that we used to have, we used to always have these big dreams for it. As far we are young now, you know, married, 3 kids, you know, mansion, you know, that kind of thing. So I just ended that kind of relationship where I had big dreams. Yes. So when I got there, I was like, please, I want to be a lady with focus. I want to be a lady with determination. I want to be a lady with purpose. So she invited me to her church. I was like, okay, let's see this church that is making somebody's child. Like, I went to the church. They're having a leadership summit, so I went to the church for it, and so many things went on the first day. I don't want to bore you with that first day story. it was leadership summit, so I did something wrong. I actually went late and I didn't know they were strict, so I had to pass through some things. Yeah, first day passed, the second day I went and the pastor was talking about soul winning, God using you as a vessel, being a purposeful person, being a person of determination, of discipline. And I was like, the message really got to me because I knew that I was broken inside, I was shattered inside, I had low self-esteem, I didn't know where I was going to, and that was just the right message. It was like the pastor was just talking to me. And it was time for prayer, so I knelt down and I was praying. And I told God, I was like, God, I really need you to use me. I really want you to cleanse me and I really want you to set me free. Like, I have so much burden inside and so much pain, and I want you to... So after I prayed, they called us for altar call and I came out and I knelt down and I was praying to God. And at first I was like, not crying, but really, because I was trying to hold myself. And at one point I couldn't hold myself anymore and I was just like crying very hard. Sorry for my face. I was crying very hard, and yeah, so at that point I surrendered and I let everything go, and that was when I heard the voice for the first time. And I heard, you are my daughter, I am proud of you, and I love you. And as much as I said it like this, you can imagine when a broken person, a charred person, you're hearing those words and you feel so much peace. And that's what I felt. I felt so much peace after that. I was so happy, like I could see myself smile, like in tears. I was smiling because it felt like someone just took my heart away and replaced it with something else, and it was amazing. And that it didn't actually end there, because after that I got a tap, and someone tapped me, and I looked up. It was like, okay, pastor's talking to you. And I looked up, the pastor said that I see you as someone with so much passion for souls. I see you in your future, and that you're gonna be a minister. And this is me that is just trying to recover from my shattered state, my broken state. And someone is telling me, I see you in the future that you're gonna be a minister. Yes, it was hard to believe at that point, because I'm just trying to hold myself. And though I prayed that God should use me, but I didn't know it was just going to be so sudden. Like, someone just going to tap me and say, you're going to be a minister, you're going to win souls, you're going to do this, you're going to do that. So it was shocking. It was actually shocking for me. Yes. It was shocking. So I took it. Another thing he told me was that I see you as an intercessor, as someone who's going to intercede for others, and your prayer life is going to change, and so much is going to change about you. The world is going to see the love of God in you. And I took it in, and definitely I found change. I saw a lot of changes in my life. I got to my hostel that day and I noticed that I could pray so much, like I prayed like never before. I did things that I didn't think I was gonna do, and things that I normally used to do, I stopped doing them. I became a lot more confident, and I am someone that I didn't know how to talk to people. I always felt I had low self-esteem in general. I always felt like every word that comes out of my mouth is wrong. Like, if I start talking, I can see something wrong. So that experience, that relationship that I started building, helped me to build my self-esteem, helped me to build myself, helped me to build my mind to carry a lot of things. My capacity began to increase, and it was a shift in my mind because of that experience. Because now I felt peace and freedom. I could smile, and the smile was genuine. Like, So it was really awesome for me. And I really want to encourage someone that no matter how you feel, I felt that way before. I've been addicted before. I've been depressed. I've been shattered. I've been heartbroken. I've been hopeless, worthless. I've been all that, but God saw me in that state and still saw me worthy and useful. So I believe that you are not exempted from this. You are not different from me. We might have different problems, but we all felt the same way, and now you can change that feeling. You can feel better by just letting go and giving God everything, and you see how much peace will come into your heart.
Choose it, you can't lose.